All right, it is the key question of our time. Does prolonged quarantine enhance Dean Cain's handsomeness or take away from it? Let's press a button. You know what? It only enhances it. You should never leave the house again. How are you,
Sam,
Dean?
Sam, I'll tell you what. It's been a forced quarantine, but it's been good to me. I've spent more time here than I've spent in 10 years, and I've actually really enjoyed it. So it's going to be tough getting me out of the house.
House. Right. Dean's house has the best view in all of California.
Nice.
He wakes up and sees the ocean every morning.
Truth.
Dean, you've never looked better. Let's focus on that. We'll get to Masters of Illusion in a second. Are you keeping busy in a particular way? But when you suggest that it's been good to you, we've talked to some other people over the last days and weeks, you know, they've got that big to-do list and they're actually getting through it, or they're discovering new things. Why has this been a pleasant time to spend at home?
My son is back from college. He and his girlfriend came back from North Carolina. So they've been here. I've been cooking and spending time with my dogs and in my backyard and swimming and going for runs and stuff, because I'm able to here. We have a very open area here. So social distancing really isn't a big deal. If you didn't know, you know, by going to the stores and things that there was a lockdown, then you wouldn't think things are any different, to be honest.
You know, it's funny because I think some people, based on where they live and their proximity to other people, say the same thing. Let's talk about Masters of Illusion Season 7. You've come to know magicians, and I suspect you know a little bit of their tricks behind the tricks. Are you still kind of amazed?
I'm amazed every single time. Even if I know the idea behind a trick. I mean, how these guys change their clothes, no idea. How that guy makes birds come out of things, I don't know. I don't get it. How guy reaches in his computer and pulls out whatever's on the screen, I still can't figure that stuff out. And I get to see it from all angles. So these guys are guys and gals, and they're extremely talented. I particularly like the close-up magic because I feel like I can catch them doing something, but I never can.
Okay, we're going to look at a fog sphere in a moment. Tell us a little bit about this trick.
The fog sphere? Honest to goodness, I couldn't tell you anything about it. I sit there and I don't know. I don't know how he does it. I don't know what goes on. I don't know what. I literally have no clue. We go through a show. We shoot it in a few days in a row. I see 70 tricks, and they're illusions, tricks, magic, whatever you want to call it. And I just don't have a clue how it gets done. Don't know.
Here comes Jason Bishop is the magician. It is the fog sphere. Look at this. Wow. I don't know.
But see, I'm right in the wings, and I don't know. It's insane.
Do you think there are any personality characteristics that magicians have in common? You know, people say that about comedians, for example.
Yeah, you know what? They tend to be quiet when you're speaking to them personally, and then they become this other person. Once they start doing their show, they become extremely dramatic and the big moves. And sometimes they're going, look over here and do this. But they're very quiet and humble when you meet them. Like I was talking to one of our illusionists that was new, and I didn't realize they were going to perform. I just thought there was somebody backstage. And so we were kind of chatting. And next thing I know, they're on stage, you know, doing illusions. But they were really quiet. And, you know, I can't tell from one person to the next. I can't tell if they're the magician or the illusionist, or if the assistant is, you get lost because we have so many different types. We have 46 different magicians on, and illusionists, and 10 of those are women. They're from all over the world. And comedians tend to be like very serious and have all kinds of issues, but these guys, no. And this guy shooting that crossbow.
Right.
Amazing. Amazing.
And then do you ever harbor the belief, Dean, or the desire, you know what, I could do that?
No, I don't want to do it. I don't want to know the tricks. I certainly don't want to be one of the people inside the box and stuff like that that gets cut in half and turned around. I just worry that they're going to slip somehow and get me. The guy who shoots the crossbow, love him to death. But I don't want to be on the other end of that. I just don't want to.
You and me both. I don't want the apple on my head. We'll tell
people.
No, keep it off. Dean, it's really good to see you. You're looking good. We'll tell people that Masters of Illusion premieres tonight at 8 o'clock. It premieres right here on KTLA. Frank, I don't know if it's the house that's keeping him looking that good, but all the stuff is agreeing with him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's probably a lot of jeans.
Yeah, that could be a